physical media is the best thing ever.
I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world.
What a cool dude. And I agree. Collecting is fun. With everyone having that thing that they're looking for.
But there are things that I look around and like you can't find anywhere.
It's great to have a front row seat to all the action. Back in 2016, my buddy Tim and I decided to open up a game store. Come join us for a look from the other side of the glass.
Co-owner of One Up Games.
My name is Nick. I'm the co-owner. Been open now for 6 years.
I started collecting probably around 2012, mostly NES and Super Nintendo stuff is what I was into, but I kind of collected everything. I used to just go on Craigslist, map out a route that I was going to take to just fill up my van that I had at the time.
It was really fun acquiring my collection. I went to a garage sale and I was just like, oh my gosh, there's a Nintendo. And this guy has some dope games.
People were basically begging you to come and take this stuff away from. Before I knew it, I had this house full of video games. And it was literally my garage, my bedroom, my kids' bedrooms, full of stuff. And then when I met Nick, it was like just sort of one of those meant to be things. And
going out and trying to find stuff on the everyday was getting harder. So my buddy saw this ad on Craigslist and went to this guy's house, and this guy had everything. So he gave me the contact information.
Nick was one of the guys, one of the many guys that called me. He was a little bit different than the other people that I had seen up to that point, because at about looking at everything that I had and going through every box that I had.
I'd like to see it all. I mean, like, who wouldn't? He's just like, okay, well, it might take a couple hours for me to get it all ready.
And not just saying, hey, do you have a little Samson, or do you have a stadium events, or will you take pictures of everything and just send it to me so I can sit at my house and kind of just look through the pictures?
It's gonna take a couple hours? Are you kidding me? What in the fuck does this guy got?
Nick actually wanted to come over and, like, treasure hunt, sort of. So that's why we kind of hit it off.
I open up the door. And it was like,
by the power of Christ, God.
There was so much stuff. I spent hours there that day. It's like, dude, save my number, man. Like, if you ever want a game or just, like, watch movies or just talk about video games and shit, we just hit it off. It was awesome.
No way you don't try it.
Holy shit!
But before I left, he's just like, hey, you want to see the garage? What? You got more than what's right here in front of us? He's just like, yeah. Come see the garage. He had so many of everything.
Yeah, that's why 6 months later we opened up the store together.
Owning the store and talking to people, learning about like their childhood memories, the things that they grew up playing, the items. I ain't gonna lie, the trades are fucking cool, man. You never know what's gonna come in those doors.
So here we are.
Hope I can get it out here this morning.
Hey man, how's it going?
Oh. You got psyched out.
Tim over at One Up Games, man. I'm just calling to let you know that I'm all set going for your trade.
Talk to you soon.
Bye-bye.
Yeah, he had one of those messages that was like, hello?
Hello?
So this guy brought in his collection from like his childhood, and it's pretty awesome. So this is some of it, and some more of it's over there, and some more of it's over there. And we're hoping to buy it this morning. And I'd like to be here for it, so that's why we were trying to get him down here, but he might come later this evening.
Is that factory seal Conkers?
No, nothing's factory. All those are reseals, but they're slid open anyway.
Okay.
But all that stuff's complete. The Donkey Kong doesn't have the expansion pack in there, but right. It's in the 64.
Right.
So.
The kind of stuff that we are seeing getting traded in is bonkers.
Dude, homeboy's digging out boxes.
Boxes! Boxes! Boxes!
I mean, I'm gonna flip the camera on really quick so you can see this. Look at this. All from one person. All those bags are filled with video games. And if you look over here, some of them are hiding behind my chair. Those are all the consoles over there. This got beautiful dude right here on top of Bartman. I just hope she has some of the overlay screens. That would be so sweet.
Yeah, it's a Dr. V64. Basically, you were able to load N64 ROMs through this, and you use the expansion port on the bottom, I believe.
That looks like Super Nintendo to me. That looks like NES.
Yeah, that's interesting. I've never seen that, actually. Wow. I'm not too
Dr. 64.
I'm not very too familiar with this.
All right, man, we'll see you soon. Bye, Sean. Well, he's on his way down. I don't know anything else. He was like, sorry it took me so long to get down there. This stuff means a lot to me. I don't really want to sell it, but he's expecting a baby. So he's like, I got to turn my man cave into a baby room. That's pretty common. He's like, hoping that you can, you know, make me a good offer on this stuff. And he's like, because I've got some good stuff. Or no, I think he said arch rivals. He's like, I've got arch rivals. And I've got like Double Dragon, and he's listing all these games, and I'm like, those are not uncommon games. But then he brings his stuff in, dude. He's got Mega Man 5 in there. He's got G.I. Joe in there.
Atlantis or American Hero?
American Hero.
Oh, sweet.
And he's got some other, like, he's got two copies of Punch-Out. He never even mentioned that. He's telling me about Double Dragon and Arch Rivals, so I'm like, did he forget he had those other guys? He also told me when he called me last week that he was gonna mail this stuff off to one of those websites to buy the games, but he didn't want to worry about packing it up and shipping it. And
right, right.
He just figured he'd bring it in locally.
I am so freaking loving this. The very first ever interchangeable cartridge thing. I'll show you too. You haven't seen a Channel F Fairchild game? That's what they look like.
Where'd the game go?
What do you want me to do with Mini-Me that you think is better?
Well,
in here, because like I'm just trying to get into your brain.
This guy has built-in outputs. I not only want you to see product comparison, I want it to be seen when you're testing to see the actual big differences that come out of it.
Mini-Me's got all these inputs on him.
Flip that guy around.
That's the one thing that sucks about this job, dude. It's like you never get time to eat. Normally, if I order food, as soon as I like open it up, I'll get a phone call. It's almost like clockwork. Or we'll get a door open.
I can see that.
Look at that. Oh, this is your first call, bro.
Guitar you need for Xbox One?
I only have a Guitar Hero Live controller on PS4 right now.
Yeah,
we all have our reasons why like video games are super important to us.
What are you talking about now?
Favorite console, game, movie.
Oh, keep doing it. The crew.
Favorite game? I don't know. That's hard. Ocarina of Time. When that game came out, it was unlike anything else that had ever come out before. Subnautica was a game that if I could erase my memory of playing that game and experience it all over again, I would definitely want to do that, because that game just had the most amazing first-time experience, of, I think, of any game I've ever played. I I recommend anybody play that.
Favorite movie?
Always sort of default to Saving Private Ryan.
If I just had to have one, it's going to be Shaun of the Dead. There's some parts that are sad as shit. That end scene?
I stopped doing them when you stopped laughing.
I'm not laughing.
And then he's like going up, he's like, I love you, man. Guy.
One of my favorite directors, like everybody else, is always raving about Spielberg. I don't know, what do you think about Spielberg?
Did I live a good life?
That turned out well, man. Really well.
Dude.
That was, yeah, that's exactly what I wanted.
I'm gonna make out with the freaking Link with that one. Oh god, he's moving on me! Oh shit.
That was perfect. That's my butt.
Get it, Gabriella. Who the hell brought in that Gabriella?
Gabriella?
From the Xena toy.
Oh, it was that guy.
Your favorite anime.
He's doing that with his.
I love you too, man.